Sydney and the Illawarra have been smashed by a monster rain event with more than 200 millimetres of rain falling in the past 24 hours, sparking hundreds of rescues.
And while the blue skies have returned, the danger isn't over yet. Some residents along the Hawkesbury-Nepean are under evacuation orders tonight after the Warragamba Dam started spilling days earlier than expected.
Midday at the breakwater, North Wollongong, and the crashing waves weren't enough to deter some.
Jesus, she's going to get bowled over here.
Seconds later, the prediction proved true. The toddler washed straight beneath the rails. The man with her jumped over them. Four ambulance crews and a rescue chopper managed to save both with only minor injuries. It was almost as if the state was hit by something similar overnight. This was Winona, north of Wollongong. Cars tossed and trashed. The damage clear by day. Mount Kira nearby, an Airbnb home turns houseboat, washed away, stopped and splintered on a downstream bridge.
We haven't had movement of an entire building before.
More startling, there were people inside at the time.
It wasn't till it actually hit the railing on the bridge that I then saw a couple of people coming out of the actual cabin itself.
Landslides and road collapses also causing chaos. Here at Stanwell Park, another in Lura, the Blue Mountains. So many roads smashed. Another, Lawrence Hargrave Drive, burst pipes spraying water back at the clouds that had just dropped it. Key transport routes severed, traffic backed up. And so many cases of cars that had risked the run and failed, submerged and likely unsalvageable, scores of drivers needing rescue.
We've had 152 across the state, 72 just being in the metropolitan area.
Here, a farmer trapped in a tractor. He'd gone out to try and rescue livestock.
And after the truck came back for the horse,
yeah.
And the truck stuck,
yeah.
Because the water too high.
And ended up needing rescuing himself. Wind strengths hit gale force and beyond, bringing down trees and power lines. Total SES call-outs, almost 3,000. The cause, a broad low-pressure trough. It had pummeled, as predicted. Nearly 150 millimetres fell at the airport. Almost 200 at Kurrajong Heights. At Darks Forest in the south, 229 mils. As the attention now shifts south towards the Illawarra, Albion Park and Nowra were hit hard. So too, Bulambi. 257 millimetres fell at Wattamolla, the heaviest falls at Brogues Creek. And in the city's north, Chatswood copped 188 mils.
In some cases, 100 millimetres of rain fell in 6 hours, which is a significant downpour.
Causing havoc too on public transport routes. Most scheduled train services delayed or cancelled. That's despite Sydney waking to clearing skies. Authorities warning the clouds might have vanished, but the threat hadn't.
Major riverine flooding is actually still likely and is likely in the Hawkesbury-Nepean and the Colo rivers.
River systems rising and the Warragamba Dam contributing. At near capacity, they let it spill from 5:45 this morning into an already saturated ground.
We are preparing for the water that is now coming out of the Warragamba Dam.
A total 27 severe weather warnings issued today, 20 for flooding.
Flood levels in some of the rivers, particularly in Western Sydney, are continuing to rise.
But for the rest of the region, better news from tomorrow.
With Sunday and Monday looking like a much more average weather system and much more average weather for us.
The system set to move offshore. Chris Reason, 7 News.